He shall receive blessings seek Him, seek the face of the God of Jacob. Response, such are the men who seek your face, O Lord.
Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when men revile you and persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for so many persecuted the prophets who were before you. The Gospel of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, today we are celebrating a great feast, a solemn day. And why we celebrate this feast today? There's a history, I'm not going to the history part, but the reason why we are celebrating All Saints Day today? Because of three reasons. First one is to honor God Almighty, the gift of many holy people. To honor God the Almighty, the gift of the saints. And second reason is to imitate those people. This group of people who are called as saints, and we are supposed to imitate those people. And these people, these saints, so-called as saints, regarded as saints, they are not born as saints, my brothers and sisters. They're not born as saints, but they became saints. So, if they can, why can't we? This question, my brothers and sisters, we have to ask for ourselves. If that person can do, why can't I do? If that person can become a saint, why can't I become a saint? And the third reason why we celebrate this feast is to pray for the intercession of the saints. We place our own intentions in the place of the Almighty God through the intercession of these saints. These are the three reasons why we celebrate today the festival, the solemnity of All Saints Day. Now, I have some questions. If you know the answers, please do answer. Simple questions, but these questions may be going on in your minds for many days, and today you will get an answer. First one, the saints are in heaven now. Saints are in heaven now. So, when we pray, we are praying for saints, no? When we pray, do they hear our prayers? Yes? Sure? Yes. But how? Simple. The saints in heaven are aware of our petitions, and these saints present our petitions to God, but interceding for us. And how is it possible? Is it is present in the scripture, Revelation chapter 5, verse 8. And then you request the sister to read this verse.
When he had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell before the Lamb, each holding a harp and golden horns full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints.
Yes, these are the prayers of the saints that the angels offer to God. And these saints are offering our prayers to God. Now, the second question. We have our own favorite saints. So maybe for example, Saint Anthony. Many people pray to Saint Anthony. So is it possible for Saint Anthony to listen to all the prayers at a time? Yes? No? Possible? How? Because for us humans, we can just listen to one person. When one person is speaking, we can listen to that person. But if third person is speaking, it becomes difficult for us to listen to the third person. Isn't it? But how can saints listen to the prayers of many people at a time? The simple reason is they are in heaven, and heaven has no time bounds, no boundaries, no space. So they can listen and they pray for us. Third question. This is the question of the challenge that Protestants. They simply ask you, why pray to saints instead of praying directly to Jesus? You can pray directly to Jesus. Why are you asking saints, the dead people, why are you asking them? These are the questions raised by the Protestants. Do you have an answer? Do you have an answer? Why are we praying to the dead people who we regard as saints instead of directly praying to Jesus? And here again we go to the scripture. 1 Timothy, letter of St. Paul, 1st letter of St. Paul to Timothy, chapter 2, verses 1 to 4.
First of all, then I urge that supplications, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings be made for everyone, for kings and all who are in high positions, so that we may lead a quiet and peaceful life in all godliness and dignity. This is right and is acceptable in the sight of God our Savior, who desires everyone to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth.
My dear brothers and sisters, on St. Paul's saying, intercede for others. And here the point we can connect with four people who brought the paralyzed man on a bed. And see, they prayed, Jesus healed the paralyzed man. And there are many instances, looking at the faith of the centurion, Jesus healed his servant. The point is, the prayer of some people, looking at their prayers, looking at their faith, God acts. This is the point, my dear brothers and sisters. We can pray to Jesus directly, but the important role, he seems to be an important role in connecting our lives to God, and we are the mediators and all the Jesus is the sole mediator, but they are also helping in connecting ourselves to God. So, coming to the point that we can learn from these saints, there are saints who are dead and there are saints who are living among us. When Mother Teresa was alive, she was called as living saint. Living saint was living among us. And there are many people who are not known, but they are living among us and they can be regarded as living saints. The saints who are dead, they are in heaven, praying for all of us always. But with regard to these living saints, my dear brothers and sisters, this is a challenge that we have. We have to become those living saints. That is our goal. We have to, through our lives that we are living, we have to be regarded as living saints. In the second reading, taken from the first letter of St. John, there St. John is saying, because of the love of God, we become the children of God. We are all children of God. We are all children of God. But through our simple actions, simple thoughts, we help you feel better. By becoming children of God, we don't lose our connection to God, but we lose that holiness. We become unholy whenever we come in any sin. But the challenge is to be always holy. Can we? Is it possible for us? Yes, it is possible. Because there are many examples before our eyes. There are many people who have given greatness. So let us pause for the Bible today and let us face ourselves before the Lord through the intercession of these saints who have been remembered and who have been forgotten. Let us ask all the saints to pray for us, to pray for our families, to pray for all those people who are in trouble. May Almighty God bless each one of us through the intercession of all the saints, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let us all stand and profess our faith in Almighty God. Together, I believe in God, the Father of my God, in the name of heaven and earth, and by Jesus Christ, His only Son of God, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified and died in the Spirit, he descended into heaven.
Amen.
see, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours can be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Which should be for all of you and for many, for People with the language.
Behold him who takes away all our sins. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
He's already there. Open the door of the heart of Jesus.
The
heavens and the lost in you.
The Lord's heavens and all our hearts. The living and the dead and the sight of the heavens. I come to consecrate myself, obey and serve me to be. I wish to be born from all my enemies, from hate and worship, and bring it impossible for all hearts to be. Receive my heart this day, O Jesus, for I am the living.
Open the